Okay, go ahead.
So we're going to watch a video by the Femitheist. A man may be a misogynist if... A comprehensive list.
And this is October 16th, 2012. And I am manslave, and my colleague...
And right now, my working title is, I guess, the Disposable Human Doing. For now, it's kind of long, but oh well.
Alright. Bring up the HD version.
Oh, disclaimer. This video does not state that all men do these things, nor does it say any one of these things on its own makes someone a misogynist.
Okay.
It simply states that a combination of a few of these things can be potential indicators of misogyny. Sorry.
Misogyny.
Well, at least the bitch gave us a disclaimer. I mean, honestly, that's pretty cool. I mean, you don't see that online. At least, you know, she tries to explain her hatred.
Can you move over a little bit toward the computer? Alright.
Pet some big monkey nose.
Hey everyone, so today I would like to present you with a list to help you define misogyny. While some of these points are similar, they're all relevant and useful, and I just wanted to make sure it's thorough. So let's begin. Okay, so this will be fun. A man may be a misogynist if, one, he pulls the Knight in Shining Armor Act and claims that he can save you. Two, he dials in a woman, choosing her as a potential mate before even an armor act, and claims that he can save you. Two, he dials in a woman.
Oh my gosh. So, when a man is actually concerned about a woman's safety and well-being, then somehow he hates her.
Well, yeah, because if you actually, you know, if there was actually a man that, you know, supposedly, you know, if there was a man that tried to help a woman, that would be going against all the bullshit she's already said, you know, because that would mean that all men aren't assholes, and, you know, that would show that there's, you know, a discrepancy between the two.
You move in a little bit closer toward the center.
Yeah, and then I'm going to blow up the screen.
No, no, you're not, because you're running back.
But it's like, yeah, you know, you can't... It's like, you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't. Because if you do it fucking one way, you know, it doesn't matter. Either way, you're fucked. Because if you do one thing, if you try to be helpful, then, you know, for instance, if you're a nice guy, you're like, you know, he's creepy.
Or he must be trying to get my pants. He thinks he can earn his way in there, man.
Yeah, and then if you're like actually, you know, a normal guy, then you'd be, you know, well, he's just an asshole, man. It's like, what the fuck do you want? Oh, that's right, you don't want any men because, you know, they're not worth living.
Oh my god.
God damn, what a bitch.
Armor Act and claims that he can save you. Two, he dials in on a woman, choosing her as a potential mate before even considering her reaction. Three, he is extremely possessive and often asks who you're with and where are you. He acts obsessively jump.
Yeah, are you serious? Yeah.
List, even of your female friends. He spends unnecessary amounts of money and always needs more.
What? Are you fucking serious? Are you serious? That sounds like something I've heard before. Can you enlighten me? Because I don't remember what it was.
Oh, it's her gender. They spend
all of it. Oh, you're right. Yeah, yeah. The thing, like, what was it the other day that it was something, it was talking about the, you know, maybe it was something I said. I remember I said something about, like, you know, the guy that thinks that he's going to get, well, I know that women, they like to spend money, so I'll just keep my credit card records and I'll keep all my stuff. You know, I won't let her know I have any money. Never mind, it'll be all good. It's like...
And then that guy gets ignored.
Yeah, pretty much. Or like, oh, I know there was something the other day that, like, we either saw or something and was talking about this. Like, oh, god damn. Oh, man, it's ridiculous. Oh my god.
I told you, you'd blow up whenever you've seen this one.
He can't handle criticism and is always defensive.
Really?
Handle criticism.
Who's like that?
Well, I don't know.
Dr. Claw? Is that Dr. Claw? Is that you that's acting like that?
Oh my God! Like seriously. Like,
I mean, she's such a fucking conspiracy theorist.
It's
I mean,
like, can't help criticism. It's like when I was at my job, you know, get called back in the office, and it's like, you know, I'm tired of getting treated like shit. What, you can't take orders from women? It's like, no, it's not the case at all. It's just, I'm tired of being treated like I'm a fucking idiot. And
I'm tired of getting stuck with all the work while everybody else goes home.
And then I got fucking gaslighted, like, what are you talking about? You weren't treated like that. Well, I feel like I was. You know, the card they always use. I feel like this murder. It's like, you know, for instance, let's say sexual harassment supposedly happens. Even though it didn't. The guy comes in, it's like, well, you know, I didn't mean it to be sexually offensive to you. You know, I didn't mean to harass you. Well, I feel bad. I feel like I've been a victim. I mean, worse than them. Why should it work with me? But it didn't work.
Because, see, that's exactly why the men's rights movement will succeed where these gynocentric bigots have failed in regards to implementing equality. Because the gynocentric hate-mongering bigots, such as this bitch right here, Dr. Claw.
Dr. Claw.
I am a cut-off fall man. I am the overseer.
If only this chair was a little bit more, you know, and it was like from the opposite side, I could be like,
oh dear.
And I'd be like petting a dog because you can't pet a cat.
So anyway, so what happens here? Because of the feminists have actually dropped the ball on China implementing equality. They said, basically, it's Trojan horse. They said they wanted equality, but that's what they said they wanted, but that's not what they actually really had their sights set on. Okay. As seen by several decades of feminism.
They don't want equality of opportunity, they want equality of outcome. They just expect it to just happen, right?
Yeah, and they don't want an equality of treatment, they want an equality of results. And basically, they like preferential, and that's why they like preferential treatment, but that's why they invent all these fucking conspiracy theories about how oppressed they are, so that equality means that they will get privilege and that men will lose.
Exactly.
You know, any, like, type
so
of freedom.
It's so fucking one-sided. Because in order for them to feel as if they're, you know, that they actually are being oppressed, it basically means the entire, like,
they have to be the dominator.
Genocide of the entire, like,
just like Dr. Collier was talking about how a global initiative and anywhere
they
from
classification and submission
and in anywhere from 90 to 99% of men need to die for the good of the planet
it doesn't need to be said that way, not a reduction of, you know, 1 to 10% or down to 1 to 10% needs to be said. You know, what we, you know, it should be put in what it actually means. Yeah, we're going to kill 90 to 99% of men. That's how it should be said, not the opposite way. Because you might be like, oh, yeah, well, maybe it means something else. No, say it like what you actually mean. I mean, fuck.
As she said, it was for the good of the planet, and that's the only long-term
only
goal
long-term
for,
logical
for,
solution.
Yeah, for peace and prosperity.
Yeah. Didn't Hitler say something like that back in the day?
Well, yeah, because he believed that in order for society
only
to be...
Only a global white race would, you know, that's the only logical long-term solution for that.
Yeah, that's
species.
What Adolf Hitler, preached, yeah.
Yeah, her dad, right?
Yeah, her dad, and now she...
Her mom was like, her last name wasn't Hitler or something, right?
It was Solana.
Yeah, because she had to, like... You know,
Valerie's
she had to have, you know, gotta keep my last name. Can't be dominated by men in any way.
Yeah, her mom's name was Valerie Solanas.
Yeah. They're pretty good parents. I mean, they taught her well, right?
He is exciting, fun, or terrifying amounts of money, and always needs more. He can't handle criticism, and is always...
I can already feel this next one is, like, I heard enough of it to know, and I'm just like... Okay, what?
Always defensive. He is exciting, fun, or charismatic, and tries to be an alpha male.
Okay, so,
just roll your eyes and shake your head. I mean,
I just don't get, like, fuck! Okay, whatever.
Oh, babe.
Okay. Just look at Cassie. It's like, why are you spontaneous? Basically, you know, I'm not fun and exciting. I must be the clear, right?
but see, that's how my former owner portrayed me, as being boring.
Yeah, so you're good, right? You don't need to die.
No, that's right. I'm not a rape supporter.
So we're safe. Thanks. I'm glad we made the cut. All right. Need to die.
Now, you have these reactions because, like Esther Viller would say, you're trying to see this poop mouth at your level. You're trying to use logic.
Yeah,
you can't be logical. You gotta use emotion.
Complete emotion.
And dysfunctionality to speak to her level, you know?
If I use my complete emotion, every time she says something, I bash my fucking head to the screen because I just can't, like, what the fuck?
Then you might cut your head and bleed to death and then go to the planet.
You're right. God damn. Like, So literally, a perfect man in her eyes would be a man who literally has no personality whatsoever, doesn't do anything except, here's my credit card, I'll go to work now, no, he wouldn't even say don't burn down a house, man.
He wouldn't even exist!
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that's why he'd be the perfect man, because he wouldn't even exist.
But like, literally, he would never be in the house, he would always be working, and the only thing that happened was he'd like probably drop his credit, he'd leave his credit card and like, he'd slip it under the door or something. He wouldn't even come in his house. He'd like, you know, I guess he'd live on the street because he can't use any of his money he works for to live in a hotel, you know. He just has to sit, you know, maybe he just stays at work. Because, I mean, basically,
wires her the money.
Yeah, he's like a mobile ATM, basically. He's paid, and
long distance ATM.
He gives her the PIN number, and that's all there is to it. So fuck.
He comes from a dysfunctional family. He had...
Dysfunctional.
Well, why would it be like that?
Yeah.
Do you think her gender would have anything to do with that?
Single parents. Well, let me say single mothers.
didn't Charles Manson come from a single mother family household?
Well, and I wouldn't be surprised if a lot of these others did too. I mean, like, in fact, hasn't that already been, like, analyzed or whatever?
Yeah.
Like, that most of these fucking fucked up serial killers come from these?
Well, I mean, you know, the overseer is not going to...
It's like, yeah, literally...
I mean, but see, that's facts and all, and the overseer...
Right. You're right. Overseer would lie to us, right?
I mean, no, I mean, you know, look at that face. Oh, look how pretty dolled up it is.
Yeah, I mean, overseer, she's like...
I mean, look at that paint job. Would that paint job lie?
I'd like to get that on my car, actually. It looks good, yeah.
Well, what you'll have to do is,
the overseer is a shining pinnacle of truth and hope in the wasteland, okay? I mean, you're out there...
You mean she's a shining beacon of hope in her own self, the wasteland?
Pretty much. I mean, you're out there fighting super mutants, and you come back to your vault at the end of the day, you come in, and you get to see the overseer's, like, shining face, just like, oh, man.
And you feel validated.
Yeah, and you're just like, oh, so validated today, and then you just look at her and you're like, tell me what I should do, tell me how I should think, because I'm just too worn out to even try and figure it out for myself. Just tell me how I should think. Gaslight me, please. You should shower it on me, yeah. Like, fucking...
Or has an abusive or passive father or a negative relationship with his mother.
Oh, hear this.
Alpha male. He comes from a dysfunctional family. He had or has an abusive or passive father or a negative relationship with his mother. He has a slanted understanding...
Exactly. Passive father... Mm-hmm. And doesn't have a good relationship with his mother. Well, gee, why would he not have a good relationship with his mother? You think her bad personality or her personality disorders would have anything to do with that?
Yeah, you know, and honestly, maybe she didn't pick up on this, but she's actually praising fathers by saying that. Because she's saying that if a father isn't passive and isn't, you know, abusive, that it's perfectly okay. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you know, the family is apparently good, even though you're working so fucking hard to destroy it. I mean, seriously, that's what she's literally saying, you know, because she doesn't even say that the mom, you know, the mom isn't dysfunctional or abusive. There's not even a fucking chance of that happening. It's literally, he has a negative relationship with her. Like, he does. Towards
like
the mother.
It's his
fault. Not like, yeah, it's not, you know, there can't be a mother who's dysfunctional.
Yeah, it's not two to tango, and it's just, oh, it's the guy's fault.
Yeah, it's all the guy's fault. But at the same time, she's also saying that if a father is present, then... It's a good influence. I don't know if she realizes that, but that's what she's saying.
understanding of reality. He dislikes expressing or has an abusive or passive father or a negative relationship with his mother. He has a slanted understanding of reality.
So like you, who thinks that in the next few decades, you're going to wipe out, what, fucking 99% of the fucking male population. Slanted perception of reality. And let's not forget that you got your message from a talking fucking dog or something. Maybe it was a tree. Who fucking knows?
Someone,
I don't even know the specific wording. I'll have to go look. But, you know, something told me that I was put here to do this. Was it God? Did God tell you that? Fuck.
It dislikes expressing or discussing feelings and hates others for their weaknesses.
Others for their weaknesses. Wow. Here's another one. It's like, you see these poop mouths. Okay, let's go. Let's just do this. Okay. Y'all see, let's say a woman's with an abusive alpha guy. Well, eventually, let's say, you know, something happens, they split up. She's like, oh, I just want a sweet, nice guy. Gets a sweet, nice guy. Starts to see, you know, him acting the way that, you know, he's not acting like the alpha, or he's showing his weakness. He's showing his feelings, his weaknesses as she perceives them.
Mm-hmm.
Then she immediately begins to despise him because he shows up. And just like, you know, with a woman, let's say a girl and her father. She sees her father ever not act like, you know, he has to be all stern and manly.
He's expected to be perfect.
And if he ever shows, you know, one little, like, crack in his, you know, like, let's say he cries or something, she immediately begins to fucking despise him. But yet, at the same time, is attracted to men like it. It's so fucking fucked up. Like, this fucked up bitch.
Rebels against authoritative figures. He dislikes expressing or discussing feelings and hates others for their weaknesses. He rebels against authoritative figures. He takes a secret that you told him and uses it against you. He threatens.
Oh, does that sound like her gender?
Yeah, it does. And it also sounds like it may happen to her at some point.
I feel so sorry for you, honey bun. Oh, that totally justifies.
Let's send her some e-flowers to make her feel better.
But that'd be sexual harassment.
You're right.
These are jobs.
You're right.
You had your feelings hurt, so that totally justifies why you want to kill all men. Oh, not all men, just 99%.
Yeah, I mean, we're not going to kill all of them. We need them to do work and take care of the infrastructure society, man.
Yeah, man.
Because these bitches aren't going to fucking be, you know, they're not going to be pressured to learn this stuff. I mean,
you expect me to learn how to do this? Well, I just want to shit my ass, man.
Not to mention they couldn't comprehend it anyway. I mean, fuck.
And you or tries to guilt you if you don't comply with his wishes. An example of this would be him saying, if you really love me, you would do this for me.
What have I heard that before?
I've heard that from my former owner, and a lot of other guys have.
God.
Okay. He calls you names or teases you in an inappropriate way or has a horrible and condescending sense of humor towards you.
So what's appropriate? I just like to know what's appropriate.
For a man not to exist according to
him. You're right. Never mind. Why don't
Because I listen to the Overseer.
Overseer's pretty cool.
He makes you feel uncomfortable and inferior or controlled around him. He does things to humiliate you in public or...
Wow, public humiliation. I think I've seen that on a couple videos. Like, what was that one, for instance, Amy Porter, let's throw that out there, you know.
Oh, yeah.
There's some, you know, fucking humiliation, like, you're so fucking fat, man, disgusting. It's like, why don't you fucking
And fucking punches him on camera for the American audience to see.
And it's like, if he's so fat and disgusting, then why the fuck did you fuck him and have a kid with him? I mean,
you see Amber Porter, she's not much better than him.
That's true.
I mean, like, damn.
Hey, let's stop the women hate.
Man.
We love all people. Man. Fucking bitch.
Or flatters you in public and then degrades you privately.
Flatters you in public and then degrades you privately. What the fuck?
don't try to use logic.
Literally, exactly. Yeah, it's just, I should just go off myself now. Because not only will it do a favor for me, because I won't have to fucking try and see what warped goddamn version of reality you live in, but also, I'd be doing you a favor, because I don't exist anymore. Goddamn.
He is unkind or spiteful behind the wheel and feels that others' mistakes are directed specifically towards him. He demands...
What? What? Oh, no, that's what women do. Like, everybody's a mistake. Oh, man, they're just trying to impress women.
Literally, I watched Leslie yesterday. This is how I woke up yesterday. I was sleeping, and I hear... screaming bullshit. Why is this can on the floor and the hole in it? There was a Coke can that apparently had like a small leak in it and it leaked on the floor. Well, you know what our solution is to get rid of the mess? Pick up the can and throw it in the sink, like full force, and it exploded everywhere. And you know what she did? She goes, "Where the fuck did you explode?" Like, oh my god, you fucking, you threw it in the sink. And it exploded, and you ask it why? Because you threw it in the fucking sink. And I was expecting to just like, you know, I was going to clean up the mess because, you know, like, I was going to, like, try to get in there and get a rag and clean it up so she would calm down because, and I was trying not to laugh, too, because, you know, because if I laughed, it would just piss her off more. So I'm just like, I'm just doing this, like, okay, and I'm like, you know, I'm gonna get a rag, and she's like wiping the mess, and she's like getting it, and I'm like getting the other spot, and Elliot, like one of his toys is in the like some of the Coke aisle. I'm like, great, now you have to wash all these toys. And she goes, no, don't. And she had a fart. I was just like,
what did she do?
She hit her elf. Like, no, don't. I don't have to. I'm like, fuck, I'm trying to be on your fucking side just so you'll calm down, but that's just too much to ask. You know, I just went in my room and waited it out, because trying to fucking help or explain, like, the reason why the can exploded is because you fucking threw it on a hard surface. I mean, maybe if it was a fucking marshmallow pillow of cloudy, like, you know, cotton candy, you could throw a Coke can at it and it wouldn't fucking explode. But yes, if you take a can that's closed with the pressure in there and all the, you know, chemicals under pressure and all that shit, and you throw it at something hard, yeah, it's gonna pop. And it's gonna go everywhere. They're like, what did you think was gonna happen? I mean, just because you're mad, you don't...
Well, like, what she expected is for it to conform...
To just go, like, yeah. Like it's going, like 2,000 miles an hour. Oh, here comes the sink. And it just, like, lands, like, bottom down. You know, like, top up. Just
gently and all that.
It's like, well, I'm sorry I made a mess. Let me clean it up, because I'm a can. I can do that. What the fuck? That's you know, that's a good example. Would you say, like,
yeah.
The world has natural laws, and whenever they happen, you know, the laws occur, and
we got 6 minutes.
Something happens, but it's not, you know, the expected reaction, even though it should be logically, not emotionally, but logically the expected reaction happens, and then it's not to their, you know, emotional expectation. Why is this stuff happening to me? It's because you aren't living on this plane of reality. You were somewhere else. And you decided that, you know, your laws are now the laws by which, you know, everything is governed, which isn't the case. It doesn't just... I mean, just because I want a bag of fucking money to appear, and it better appear, I'll be mad. It doesn't mean it's just going to happen. I mean, it doesn't mean I can just go into a bank and rob the bank and just be like, I'm mad, so give me this money. Because I'm mad, and they're just going, oh, you're right, you know what, here's all the money. Like, what the fuck?
Desires complete attention and requests you to be available or spiteful behind the wheel and feels that others' mistakes are directed specifically towards him. He demands or desires complete attention and requests you to be available whenever he wants you.
Wow. You know, that reminds me of something that you told me about, and that you commented on a video about. What video? It was recently in the video, and you commented, and you're like, you know, whenever my owner wanted to have sex, I was expected to do it, even if I didn't particularly want to at that time.
Yeah, that was that 50 Shades of Grey, what the fuck, video by Lacey Green, that poop mouth bigot that's like friends or whatever with Anita Sarkeesian. Which, but with the ironic thing is, see, Anita Sarkeesian is the person that does the feminist frequency videos, on YouTube, and she is like, we thought she was one of the most hardcore, gynocentric, hate-mongering, bigot, patriarchy, conspiracy theorist pieces of shit out there, until we found Dr. Claw.
Dr. Claw's big value.
Now, an ironic thing is, I, Manslave, the guy that runs the Validation Warfare YouTube channel, I'm in communication with the Femitheist, that's what she calls herself, but you know, she nicknames herself the Overseer, but we call her Dr. Claw, because, you know, it's like a Saturday morning cartoon character.
You won't stop us, man.
Yeah, I told you, will not stop us, we will succeed. I mean, that's how she is.
Pretty much.
So anyway.
She's like a little blue, like, helmet with a little faceplate. Fuck. Or, you know, she's like, fuck, she's all of them. She's Skeletor, Shredder, I mean, fuck.
So anyway, this girl here, the Femitheist on YouTube, I'm in contact with her. We send messages back and forth. The ironic thing is, she says that she despises Anita Sarkeesian.
I thought she didn't hate anybody, though.
Well, I'm going to have to show you the screenshot of the correspondence and all
hey,
that.
Hey, you're using a secret against her. Don't do that.
Oh, because I'm an asshole. Anybody care to pop a cap in me? For the good of the planet?
You're right. Maybe she'll do it.
Oh, no, she don't got the guts, remember? Like, she's just waiting for it to just naturally happen.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
We got about 2 minutes. I'm going to start a new video, so don't do anything.
That's on.
All right, and just for the audience, I am Manslave of the Validation Warfare YouTube channel, and this is
Disposable Human Doing for now. I guess.
Yep, and we are the duo of Validation Warfare.